Hello everyone, thank you so much for joining me here today. If you're new, I'm Amanda. Welcome to the channel where we are all about shattering the mental health stigma. If you haven't already, make sure you make sweet, sweet love to that subscribe button so you're not missing any of these reactions, any of my vlogs about my mental health journey, or any of my celebrity interviews about their mental health journeys. Today's reaction is a request from one of my lovely Patreons, Hyper Dragon. Thank you so much for your continued support. If you haven't had a chance to check out my Patreon yet, make sure to do so. I'm going to link that in the description below so you can see what I'm up to with my mental health outreach, get priority song requests, ask questions to my celebrity guests, get to chat with me on monthly live streams, and so much more, and every single dime goes toward my mental health outreach. So today, I'm going to be listening to Cyhra, I think is how you say it, Battle From Within. I have no idea what band this is, what genre this is. I don't even know if this is a band or a person. I literally know absolutely nothing, so I'm going in totally blind, which is kind of my MO. If you've been watching this channel, I always go in blind with stuff, but in this case, I don't even know if it's a group or a person, or it could be Elmo singing for all I know, but as always, I am always curious and excited to learn new things and try new things and take a leap of faith, so thank you for joining me here today to do that with me. Let's go. I thought it was backwards from the rails. What's wrong with my screen? Because while I had two parents that very much loved each other, I think in some way or another we were all detained from our emotions at some point in our lives, and that's kind of where we transitioned from childhood to adulthood, is where we were taught to kind of try and turn our emotions off or ignore them or not have a healthy relationship with them. And in my case, it wasn't my parents, it was more my peers. I grew up in a small town where I had to shut off from my emotions and stuff, because to have emotions, to be vulnerable, to struggle with mental health was definitely perceived as a weakness, and unfortunately it still is in that area, and that's just simply not true. And I love just reminding people you do matter and you're so loved, and you might not feel it when you're in the throes of the depression, because that's what it tells you, that's what it does, is it gets into your brain and it tells you that you're unlovable and you don't matter and people would be better off without you, and none of that is true. So I am so grateful for another group, another set of people that are willing to share this message. It's very, very much an important one. But yeah, that's a hard one. How do you heal a broken heart when they expect we'll follow patterns? I saw my dreams just disappear. Form your own reactions. Become a child of fear. Yes, that is what people perpetuate nowadays, is that we live in fear, that we live in fear of the other side, that we live in fear of our emotions, that we live in fear of loving or fear of trusting or fear of other people. And it gets to the point where that consumes you, to where you don't know how to love anymore, be it yourself or other people. You don't know how to function. You don't know how to connect with yourself because you're just stuck in fear. And that is what closing off does. That's what shutting off does. It turns you into a child of fear that's birthed from all the trauma and all of the people that invalidate you. These wounds won't heal. There's some dreams that may or may not come true is the most heartbreaking thing I've ever had to come to terms with. And while fortunately I can see myself coming out of that and I see the potential of my dreams coming true these days, it's still very hard when you're confronted with the very real possibility that the things you wanted most may not happen. And that might be because of loss, that might be because you know, your circumstances changed and certain things just aren't viable to you at that point. But, oh God, like letting go of that. When you feel like your life's just falling apart and everything in it's falling apart, and you can hear the reference to the phone ringing from afar struck me, because sometimes you kind of forget those people that are there and that are close to you, because again, depression gets into your mind and almost poisons you, and you forget about those people that are there. So the phone ringing from afar, that's what I took that to mean, is you have almost distanced yourself, and usually it's not what you want to do, it's that you're distancing yourself from people to see who believes you're worth fighting for. So if you know someone that is pushing away like that, it's typically because they don't know how to talk to you and they just want to know that they're worth fighting for. But yeah, the House of Cards is obvious, that you just feel like the slightest little thing will tear your world apart and everything will fall out from underneath you. And it's hard to find that foundation once you start coming out of that darkness. It's hard to find that foundation to begin to really move forward and to begin to really find structure and find something more solid. I love the Gryffindor scarf. Because I do feel like we're being forced to almost deny and defy our own beings, our own existence, our own humanity. We're being forced to deny that by a society that doesn't understand. And you can't win that. You will never win that. You will never, ever, ever win when you're trying to deny and defy who you are and what you need deep down inside and what your natural urges are. You can't win that. You can't win that battle. I really like the idea of the battle from within, because it can be seen as, you know, the inner turmoil that is, you know, moving outwards, that permeates, that percolates inside, or it can be the strength from within. So I think that this can kind of go both ways, where it can be, there is that darkness in you, there is that difficulty to cope, but there's also the strength, there's the soldier, there's this fighter inside of you, and that's really the only way to fight, is from within.
Fathers, for the lonely, the forgotten, you can never win.
help is available. That is true. And I'm going to link some of the organizations and stuff below, just in case you are needing some help. But as always, you can reach out to me. There's always someone there. And there is always help available. There's always someone that cares. You do very much have a purpose to be here, a meaning in this world, even if it feels like you don't. I spent 14 years feeling like I didn't have any purpose, any meaning, that I was just kind of trudging along, that the world didn't want me anymore, that I was a waste of space in the world, and that's a hard way to live. And I finally found, once I started healing, that a lot of my purpose is to help other people find theirs, to help other people find their strength. But I oh my God. I think I needed that today, to be honest. I promise that I'm going to start coming forth with some of my current challenges and current situations in my vlog posts in the coming weeks, because I do want to communicate with you guys and share with you guys what's going on. But I'm not gonna lie, I definitely needed this today, just as much as I'm sure some of you did. It's powerful just to have that reminder that we are all valuable, we are all loved. There isn't one person that's more worthy than another person. Think about it. The most beautiful women in the world have been cheated on. The most successful, powerful men have succumbed to depression and suicidal ideation. You know, some people get turned down for a job. Think about it. Michael Jordan was told that he wasn't good enough for his basketball team. Marilyn Monroe was told that her figure wasn't good enough to be a model. Walt Disney was told his ideas weren't good enough. To someone. Okay, to someone, those people weren't good enough. But look what happened to them, because they knew deep down inside they were, and they didn't let one person's rejection or one person's opinion of them destroy that. And that's a message that I really have to be continuously telling myself these days, is you do have to just own where you are and what you're feeling and what you're going through. And as long as you're not going against that, as long as you're not trying to say, you know, I don't want to feel the feelings on this side of the spectrum, so I'm just going to deny them all and try and be happy all the time. That doesn't work. That doesn't happen, because we are human and we do have emotions. And when we can go through that, when we can just say, okay, this is uncomfortable and it stinks, what can I do to find some little bit of happiness in this situation? Even if the situation is awful, like the loss of a loved one or separation or something like that, just finding something to connect to, the slightest little thing, finding a good book, reconnecting with a friend, watching your favorite movie, there's always something that you can do. Going outside and just finding something in nature that you can connect with, that one little tiny thing to tether you to your reason, to your beauty, to your world, that one thing to tether you, is all it really takes to start moving forward. I became really obsessed, this is silly, but you know, it's not silly, it's amazing. I became really obsessed with dewdrops on this really specific type of leaf we have here. It's actually a weed, but I'm gonna say leaf because weeds are flowers too, if you get to know them, as my best friend would say. And the way the droplets of water, be it the dew or the sprinkler or whatever, the way it looks on these little blades literally looks like little diamonds. And I remember sitting there one time and just staring at that, because it's really all I could do. I was going, the inside in here was really, really, really ugly. So I had to find something that I found beautiful to counter that. But again, I want to reiterate that the real battle within us is when we're trying to reject the messages that our minds and our hearts are sending us, when we're trying to reject who we are, when we're trying to reject our very human responses to things. I think that's where a lot of the turmoil comes in. I really love this song. It was simple, you know, it wasn't anything really complex, but the message was incredibly powerful. And I'm all for uplifting people. I'm all for encouraging them and reminding them of their own strength and power and beauty. I hope that whoever needed to see this today saw it. As always, make sure that you like, make sweet, sweet love to that subscribe button, like I said. Share this video, because you never know who might need to see it. And of course, share your story here in the comments so we can help shatter the mental health stigma, because I just want to create a safe place where you can come without judgment and just talk, share your story, share your struggles, share your successes. I want to hear it all. I love you guys so, so, so much. Mwah.